You know, one of the most popular questions that I'll get asked in private lessons during the week or through Skype, you know, when I do sessions with different people around the world, if I maybe even get some emails from people who are members of my website, is the questions are really, you know, a lot of them start at organizing a practice schedule. How do you get organized day to day with a really good variation of topics and, you know, really have a proper practice plan? Without it, it's important because without it, you're going to drift day by day through study topics and never really properly address your short and long-term goals. You know, the biggest factor involved with developing your guitar playing skill is to have a large amount of playing topics that you practice within a daily routine. And that routine, it needs to constantly vary. You know, quite recently I did a video about varying scales when you're practicing. It's a good video. Go watch it. It's called Stop Doing Hours of Scales. In the lesson plan, I actually include one of my old scale practice sheets that I used, and the discussion touches on the importance of changing up your scale routine. But that changing up of a routine, it needs to happen in a large way with all of your topics, you know, through multiple days, and things should constantly change as you're practicing your material. Another area is really having more discipline with topics, and your practice schedule can really reflect that in some very interesting ways too. I'm going to talk about that in this video because you do not want to study anything that you can already play. You want to be moving through material and practicing things that you cannot perform instead of, you know, going and practicing stuff that you can already play. That will not progress you. That'll stagnate you, actually. You'll just kind of stay the same all the time. You need to be stretching yourself and forcing yourself into things that you have trouble with, and that's how you're going to grow as a player. So what we're going to do in this video lesson is we're going to cover a lot of these topics. We're going to look at how you can create a list of subjects and move through ideas that you can't do, force yourself into furthering your education in some really specific ways, and using some skills and some topics that will allow you to progress as a guitar player and get better and better at your skill set. All right, the first place that you need to look into and organize and analyze for your topics of study is to understand, once you've selected something that you're going to work on, where you are at with that information, where your knowledge base is for a certain topic. There needs to be some kind of determination made for where your skill level is at for a topic and where you need to progress further with that information. So we need to kind of narrow this down because it's going to be very difficult to describe in generalizations. So let's choose a topic here. I'm going to select a topic of the seventh quality chords. So, you know, let's say you're going to study those. Now, if you wanted to learn seventh quality chords, to do this most effectively, you're going to want to begin by making a list of the popular seventh chords out there. So that would include major seventh, minor seventh, dominant seventh, the half diminished, or what's also called minor seventh flat five, and the fully diminished, often referred to as the diminished seventh chord. Okay, so once you organize everything that has to do with the topic, and the next step is going to be moving into a list being made also of what you do not understand about the topic. So maybe you know some seventh chords, but you don't know very many. So you need to focus on which chord patterns that you can play now on the sixth, fifth, and fourth strings, because that's where we root chords, scales, and arpeggios. It doesn't matter what you're studying, whether it's a chord pattern, scale idea, arpeggio ideas, across the neck. You root everything from sixth, fifth, and fourth strings, to a lesser degree also third string. So you organize that as sort of the next plan of attack, and then you're going to start drawing things out. I'm a firm believer of using guitar neck diagrams, chord diagrams, you know, blanks, that is, and drawing out what you want to study with a pencil to paper, organizing it, you know, not computers. I think it's much better done on just a piece of paper sitting at your, you know, practice desk, or, you know, someplace in your home, your kitchen table, even if you want to, and draw this stuff out. Something happens in your mind, you lock down information much better if you take pencil to paper. So that would be my next suggestion. And that would work the same if you were doing scales or arpeggios or whatever. So now that you're sort of at that level with things, you've organized the topic that you want to study, you've taken a look at everything that's going to be involved in your study plan, you've gone through what you know right now and then what you need to learn, and then you've organized it to the guitar neck in some way, whether it's through chord diagram systems or guitar fingerboard layout system. The next thing that you're going to want to do is begin practicing this in some kind of a drill. So you need some method of attack into this information, and you want to have it varied through your days with some kind of an ability level gauge. So maybe that's a logbook that you're using and a practice schedule logbook. Maybe it's just some kind of a recording that you make on your phone or something like that. So you want to log what you're doing and begin going through drills with the study of the information to get your fingering technique much smoother and your whole ability level more precise with what it is that you're studying. And that could last a while. You could be doing that for 5 weeks or 8 weeks, or you could be doing it for 3 months. But somewhere around that the mark of about 3 months, you're going to have that information at a pretty good level already. So now, you know, in the case of not knowing or which direction to go or not knowing what to do, there's hundreds and hundreds of videos out there on YouTube. There's, you know, different kinds of courses. I have my course on guitar out there. If you're totally lost and you do not really know how to attack your information and you don't have a teacher to help guide you, then you're going to have to somehow use the internet to track down the information that you require. For instance, even in my free material just on YouTube, if it were to be maybe a study of chords, I've got a great two-part series called Harmonizing Movable Chord Shapes. I'll put a link to it in my Blogger account, you know, for you, and that would be a fantastic place to start, you know, and just, you know, go into there, you'll get all the layouts of everything, you'll understand how to get moving along. But the step one process of all this is to understand your knowledge for a topic, organize it, and begin forming a very concise practice plan. Okay, the next area that I want to work on has to do with subjects and the importance of focusing on musical subjects, because there are so many guitar players who really just play songs. You know, they sit down, they grab their guitar and start playing some old Led Zeppelin tune, or maybe if they're a fan of rock and metal, they might play a Metallica song. You know, maybe they're like Pink Floyd, you know, David Gilmour, they're jamming on some of that. Maybe it's Dire Straits and Mark Knopfler. I mean, it could be anything, you know, that's just fun to play and you learn where to move your fingers around to, but it really doesn't take you further in the department of being a musician. You know, you can lock yourself in for so long at just being a guitar player, which is fun and everything, but if you have a desire to go further with your playing, you really need to focus on musical subjects. So one thing that will happen, and that usually occurs with just people who go to music colleges or, you know, university programs for music, is that there's an intensity of working through a group of music subjects across a week when you get to music college that is just unlike anything you've ever done. And the nice thing really with this is that you don't have to spend a ton of money to go to a professional music, you know, degree or you know, college diploma to get yourself doing this. You can do this yourself at home. Now, anybody can do this stuff. You can just divide up your week into using a practice routine that follows some type of a musical subject heading with topics, like maybe, you know, divide up your week into, you know, write it on a piece of paper if you have to, you know, something like music theory, rhythm, ear training, guitar technique, music reading, transcription, composing, arranging, you know, that kind of thing. I think you're getting the idea of what I'm doing. I'm listing really what you would have as topic headings if you were going to a college or university program for music. And the approach at creating an at-home practice schedule like this that follows musical subjects just like you would study if you were at a music school, it's absolutely amazing what starts to happen. You know, if you're lost on certain ideas of what to do, you could go on the internet and look up these topics of what should I study if I was going to do composing? What should I study if I wanted to work on rhythm? Maybe you could even go to your local library and pull out some different books and start studying different elements of composing and arranging and music theory and just build really a whole program for yourself around these subject headings. You know, all too often, really, the home guitar player, the at-home guitarist, spends way too much of their time only learning songs. And I know it's fun, and it is, you know, it's a great, you know, feeling to learn how to play a song in time and, you know, eventually hit that album speed with the tempo and everything. But, you know, if you were a college or university student, you would barely do that, of course. You would be so immersed in real music subject headings. And if you only were to spend a couple of years, let's say, at home with that kind of an attitude, really following those subject headings that I listed, it would really make a huge difference for yourself as a guitar player, because it would be pushing you more in the direction of being a musician who plays guitar rather than just a guitarist who's, you know, jamming for fun and, you know, doesn't really know anything when they put the guitar down in the corner of the room or back in the case. So if you have a desire to really push your skills up to higher and higher levels, organize a practice approach, a study routine that touches on all of those music subject topics. So I got one more subject heading I want to run through with you on designing your practice schedule. And before I wrap up, I want to just, you know, go through this one. It's very important. It's probably one of the most important things that I've done, one of the most valuable study techniques I've had, you know, shared with me over the years and implemented from some of my favorite guitar teachers. And this one thing is the value that comes from working within short time frames done using a timer. So I've got this timer here I wanted to show you. This is really what I use. It's a simple egg timer, I think. I don't even know if I paid $10 for this. It's just one of these cheap, you know, kitchen egg timer things. And when you work within time frames, using a timer like this, you know, you just, you know, you set it for 3 or 4 minutes, you work within that time frame, and then you wind up, you know, jumping to another subject when this goes off. Or maybe if you were working on a major scale for 3 minutes, this thing goes off, you jump over, you start working on a minor scale, this thing goes off, you know, you shift over to maybe, I don't know, harmonic minor or a mode or whatever it may be, or maybe you switch completely to arpeggios or chords or whatever. So what happens is when you work with a timekeeping device like this, you create a very different kind of learning environment, and you also get a lot more done in a lot less time, because, you know, once you establish a short time period, and I'm talking, again, you know, about 3 or 4 minutes or so, you know, for one topic, for a single area of study, and then you move on to another area, you take so much better control over what's going on and how you schedule your time and what happens during your practice sessions if you use a timer like this. And when you work within short time frames, you can actually study a lot more material and have a lot better focus and study a lot longer. You know, you've heard these stories of people like Steve Vai and Joe Satriani and Yngwie Malmsteen and some of these other, you know, amazing guitarists out there, where they were practicing at some points in their career for, you know, 8 hours a day, 9 hours, 12 hours a day. It seems unfathomable, like how could you possibly do that? Well, this is how they did it. They just did things in very short time frames and worked through a whole collection of ideas of study that they designed for themselves, much like I'm describing to you in this video right here. So when you schedule your guitar study in a day with time frames, you can actually study for longer and you can have better focus, and you won't suffer from the common, you know, feeling of burnout that happens when you spend too long on one topic and one idea. So if you take away anything from this discussion here, get into the valuable habit of using a timer to track your minutes and to just help you move through more topics and study more music and more guitar skills on a daily basis. It's just absolutely the ticket to amazing guitar playing. Well, I'd like to end the discussion by saying thanks for joining me. If you want to learn more about what I do as an online guitar teacher, then head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for your free lifetime membership. When you want more, you can always upgrade to either a basic or a premium lesson package and start studying the guitar courses I've organized for the members of my website. Also, I'd be interested to hear your thoughts on all this in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks again, and we'll catch up next week for another episode of the Guitar Blog Insider. Hi everybody, Andrew Wasson here from creativeguitarstudio.com. I've been a professional guitarist for over 25 years now, and I've been teaching guitar for even longer than that. But today I want to talk to you about your current situation by discussing the study of guitar and the time that you have available to put into it. If you're like most people, you're working a 9-to-5 job and you're working 8 hours a day, 40 hours a week, that's 160 hours a month. How much free time does that leave you left over to study guitar? Let's say you can maybe fit in an hour or so, around 4 or 5 days in a week when you have the free time. And if that is the case, wouldn't you want to make the most of that 1 hour of study, practicing a highly organized, step-by-step, well-structured guitar career? Without a structured plan, it's pretty easy to waste time. You know, a lot of times it happens by just focusing on playing through a bunch of stuff you know, songs you know, riffs you already know, licks that you're familiar with. But practicing stuff you already know will not make you a better guitar player. You need a constant supply of fresh material. You know, if you practice guitar by just playing stuff you already know, before you realize it, time ticks on, time ticks by, and that valuable period of time that you have every day, it gets lost. If left alone, those hours lost every day turn into lost weeks, lost months, and then eventually lost years of wasted time. You'll still be the same guitar player that you were before because you never challenged yourself. I've seen it dozens and dozens of times in my own studio here. But you know, you can change that. In the valuable time that you do have every day, you can start studying a comprehensive guitar course that'll not only educate you, but it'll turn you into a well-skilled musician. So if you want to learn more, sign up for a free account through my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. The general access membership is absolutely free to join. Come in, get your feet wet, and when you're ready, you can go for the paid membership. What you'll discover in there is the most comprehensive guitar curriculum available online. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.